Hi, hello, this is Esther, Faculty of English. Now, let us discuss about nonverbal communication skills, definition and examples. According to Indeed data, communication skills consistently ranked among the top skills mostly common listed new job postings by employees in 2020. Having strong communication skills is essential for building both personal and professional relationships. What is nonverbal communication? Nonverbal communication is the transfer of information through the use of body language, including eye contact, facial expressions, gestures, and more. For example, smiling when you meet someone conveys friendliness, acceptance, and openness. Everyone uses nonverbal communication all the time, whether they know it or not. Nonverbal communication is dependent on seeing and analyzing physical movement, as opposed to verbal communication or the use of language to transfer information through written text, speaking, or sign language. Why is nonverbal communication important? Nonverbal communication is important because it gives us valuable information about a situation, including how a person might be feeling, how someone receives information, and how to approach a person or group of people. Paying attention to and developing the ability to read nonverbal communications is an invaluable skill. You can leverage at every stage of your career. Several ways nonverbal communication can support your ability to communicate effectively in the workplace, including supports to your message, communicates messages, communicates intention, conveys feelings, offers support, showcases your personality, indicates a desired action. Discipline tension using a calm tone of voice, right? Here are types of nonverbal communication. There are several types of nonverbal communication should be aware of, including body language, movement, posture, gesture, space, paralanguage, facial expressions, eye contact, touch, etc. ఇలాంటివన్నీ కూడా మనం చూసుకుంటే, ఫస్ట్ మనము లెట్ అస్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ బాడీ లాంగ్వేజ్. బాడీ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇస్ ద వే సమ్ వన్ స్టేట్స్ దేర్ బాడీ నేచురల్లీ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ది సిట్యుయేషన్ ఆన్ ది ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ అండ్ హౌ దే ఆర్ ఫీలింగ్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్, సమ్ వన్ మైట్ క్రాస్ దేర్ ఆర్మ్స్ ఇఫ్ దే ఆర్ ఫీలింగ్ యాంగ్రీ ఆర్ నర్వస్. చాలామంది కూడా చూస్తూ ఉంటాము ఫేషియల్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్స్ కానీ బాడీ లాంగ్వేజ్ కానీ. డిఫికల్ట్ కన్వర్జేషన్స్, ఆర్మ్స్ ఫోల్డెడ్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ ది బాడీ, మినిమల్ ఆర్ టెన్స్ ఫేషియల్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్స్, బాడీ టర్న్డ్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ యూ, ఐ డౌన్ క్యాస్ట్ ఆర్ మెయింటైనింగ్ లిటిల్ కాంటాక్ట్, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనం చూస్తూ ఉంటాం. బాడీ లాంగ్వేజ్ రిఫర్స్ టు ది నాన్ వర్బల్ సిగ్నల్స్ దట్ వీ యూజ్ కమ్యూనికేట్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ఎక్స్పర్ట్స్. దీస్ నాన్ వర్బల్ సిగ్నల్ మేకప్ ఏ హ్యూజ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ డైలీ కమ్యూనికేషన్. From our facial expressions to our body movements, the things we don't say can still convey volumes of information. It has been suggested that body language may account for between 60-65% of all communication. Understanding body language is important, but it is also essential to pay attention to other causes such as the context. In many cases, you should look at signals as a group rather than focusing on a signal action. Here's what to look for when you are trying to interpret body language. Difficult conversation or an uncomfortable fact of life. It's the relaxed facial expressions that breaks out into a genuine smile with mouth upturned and eyes wrinkled. It can be a tilt of the head that shows you are listening, sitting, or standing upright to convey interest, directing attention with a hand gestures. It can also be taking care to avoid a defensive arms crossed postures or restlessly tapping your feet. When you can read signs like these, you can understand the complete message of what someone is telling you. right? You will be more aware of people's reactions to what you say and do, and you will be able to adjust your body language to appear more positively engaging and approachable. Okay. Yeah, body language examples, difficult examples, so many difficult examples. Okay, arms folded in front of the body, minimal or tense facial expressions, body turned away from you, eye downcast, maintaining little contact, okay, etc. Okay, second one, facial expressions. Think for a moment about how much a person is able to convey with just facial expression. A smile can indicate approval, happiness, or approval or happiness. Okay, a frown can signal disapproval or unhappiness. In some cases, our facial expressions may reveal our true feelings about a particular situation. Right, while you say that you are feeling fine, that look on you are just a few examples, emotions that can be expressed via facial expressions: happiness, sadness, anger, surprise, disgust, fear, confusion, excitement, desire, okay, contempt. The expression on a person's face can even help determine if you trust or believe what the individual is saying. One study found that the most trustworthy facial expression involved a slight raise of the eyebrows and a side smile. This expression that the research suggested conveys both friendliness and confidence. Facial expressions are also among the most universal forms of body language. The expressions used to convey fear, anger, sadness, and happiness are similar throughout the world, right? Researcher Paul Ekman has found support for the university of a variety of facial expressions tied to particular emotions, including joy, anger, fear, surprise, and sadness. Research even suggests that we make judgments about people's intelligence based upon their faces and expressions. Right. One study found that individuals who had narrower faces and more prominent noses were more likely to be perceived as intelligent. People with a smiling, joyful expression were also judged as being more intelligent than those with angry expressions. Right. Next, eye contact. Some are blue and some are green, some are brown and other has that's right, the subject is eyes, but more impartially are importantly, but more importantly, that the color of someone's also a mode of communication. A person can communicate with their eyes and never say a word. Our eyes show emotion or interest, and if thought about too much, making eye contact can become awkward and uncomfortable. Have you thought about eye contact as a skill? Right. As adult, using appropriate eye contact can be difficult. What about youth? Your eye contact can be tied to so many life skills that it's important for our youth to practice and learn about eye contact as a communication skill. Right. Consider for a moment using your eye contact to show empathy, concern for others, to manage feelings, to help with the communication. Those are all life skills that youth will grow and develop as they mature into successful adults. Don't worry. If eye contact is something you struggle with, it's likely that everyone will have a conversation sometime where they can identify some characteristics of odd eye contact as well as characteristics of really great eye contact. Remember to learn from that, right? When whichever extreme you experience, take a mental note of what you liked and didn't like. According to conversation aid, there are few points that can summarize importance eye contact. Right, let us see. Eye contact opens and closes communication. Increased eye contact is associated with credibility and dominance. Lack of contact and blinking are interpreted as submissive states, communicate hostility. High status people are looked at and look more while taking or while talking than listening, right? So let us discuss about gestures. Gestures can be some of the most direct and obviously body language signals, waving, pointing and using the fingers to indicate numerical amounts are all very common and easy to understand gestures. Some gestures may be cultural, however, so giving a thumbs up or a peace sign in another country might have a completely different meaning that it does in the United States. Okay, here for some example, let us see some example of just a few common gestures and their possible meanings. Clenched fist can indicate anger in some situations, or solidarity in others. Okay, thumbs up and thumbs down are often used as gestures of approval and disapproval. The okay gesture, made by touching together and the thumb and index finger in a circle while extending the other three fingers, can be used to mean okay or all right. In some parts of Europe, however, the same signal is used to imply you are nothing. In some South American countries, the symbol is actually a vulgar gesture. The V sign, created by lifting the index and middle finger and separating them to create a V shape, right, means peace or victory. In some countries in the United Kingdom and Australia, the symbol takes an offensive meaning when the back of the hand is facing outward. These types of postures can be indicated of hostility, unfriendliness and anxiety. How have you ever heard someone refer to their need a personal space? Have you ever started to feel uncomfortable when someone stands just a little too close to you? Yeah, some people are physical distance often indicates a closer relationship or greater comfortable individuals. It usually occurs during intimate contact such as hugging, whispering or touching. This belongs to personal space, okay? This belongs to personal distance, personal space, intimate distance, social distance, public distance, right? Understanding body language can go a long way toward helping you better communicate with others, right? And interpreting what others might be trying to convey, while it may be tempting to pick apart signals one by one, it's important to look at these nonverbal signals in relation to verbal communication, other nonverbal signals and the situation. You can also focus on learning, right, more about how to improve your nonverbal communication to become better and letting people know what you are feeling without even saying a word. Right? Types of nonverbal communication. Okay, several types. Okay, several types of nonverbal communication. Right? Body language. Okay, facial expressions and eye contact and gestures, also most and more important nonverbal communication skills. Okay, now paying attention is important, picking up nonverbal cues. Okay, how to read body language. Okay, use of facial expressions, use of legs, use of arms, postures, ivanni kuda manaki chala chala important. How to improve nonverbal communication, do a body language test. Okay, notice how your emotion feel physically, be intentional about your nonverbal communications, mimic nonverbal communication. You find effective nonverbal communication is as an essential part of having excellent communication skill, right? Using nonverbal communication interviews lo kuda adugutare em anadutare, nonverbal communication is an essential part of the interview. It is important both to read and interpret the nonverbal cause of your interviewer and to respond with appropriate body language throughout. Here are a few tips for using nonverbal communication in your next interview, right? Stand up when your interviewer enters the room and greet them with a reasonably confident handshake. Okay, use natural and conversational intonation without going up or down to unnaturally. Okay, next video lo malli nenu meeku cheptanu simple when greeting your interviewer and naturally throughout your interview. Sit with your shoulder back and chin up to convey confidence. Okay, use gestures naturally without being distracting. Speak with a reasonable, confident tone so your interviewers can easily and clearly understand you without being too loud. okay, used naturally. Smile when greeting your interviewer and naturally throughout your interview. Sit with your shoulder back and chin up to convey confidence. Place both feet on the ground or crossed at the ankles and lay your hands on the top of the other on the table to express openness and friendliness. Use gesture naturally without being distracting. So, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనం చేయాలా. స్పీక్ విత్ రీజనబుల్ కాన్ఫిడెంట్ టోన్ సో యువర్ ఇంటర్వ్యూస్ కెన్ ఈజీలీ అండ్ క్లియర్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్ యూ వితౌట్ బీయింగ్ టూ లౌడ్. సో ఇవన్నీ మీరు విన్నారు కదా. నెక్స్ట్ వీడియోలో ఇంకా మరికొన్ని విషయాలతో మళ్ళీ కలుసుకుందాము. అంతవరకు సెలవు. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.